Hey, how you doing today? I am Tequila Coleman. In today's video, we're going to pray against the spirit of poverty. I want to break off the spirit of poverty off of our God-ordained believing spouses and our prodigal spouses. Now, before we go into prayer, I want to turn your attention to a few scriptures so that you can get understanding behind how the spirit of poverty comes into your life, okay? Because some of you may find yourself dealing with a spirit of poverty, and once I turn your attention to these scriptures, you might begin to receive some type of insight and revelation, okay? So let's start in Proverbs chapter 10, verse 4. The NIV version reads, "Lazy hands makes for poverty, but diligent hands brings wealth." So the spirit of laziness will come upon a person's life whenever you are operating in laziness. Whenever you are just, sitting around being lazy, you invite the spirit of poverty to come upon your life. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 18 in the KJV, it say, "Poverty and shame shall be to him that refuses instruction." Okay, so whenever you reject wise counsel or advice or even the scripture, you are inviting into your life the spirit of poverty. Okay, Proverbs 21, verse 17 reads, "Whoever loves pleasure will be a poor man." Now, pleasure is referring to when you're partying, drinking, smoking, fornicating, things of that nature, right? And so this will bring you, this will invite the spirit of poverty to come upon your life because it kind of goes back to the prodigal son, the story of the prodigal son in the Bible, when he was off in wild, reckless living. He lost everything because he was doing exactly what the scriptures say. He was just doing activities that brought him pleasure, and as a result of it, he lost every single thing. Okay, Proverbs chapter 28, verse 19, reading from the NIV, it say, "Those who work their land will have abundant food, but those who chase fantasy will have their fill of poverty." So for some of you, even your prodigal, they are chasing fantasies, okay? They're chasing, these fantasies in the mind, right? When they already know this stuff ain't going anywhere, it's not of God, it's not God's best, right? And so chasing fantasy invites the spirit of poverty into your life. Last one, Proverbs 28, verse 22, "A stingy man hastens after wealth." Okay, so if you are stingy, if you are mean, if you just holding on to things and you just, refuse to be a giver and have that giving heart, you invite in the spirit of poverty. Okay, so I want to go to God in prayer just to break off this spirit of poverty that has entered in. Like I said, it could have come into your life and even your prodigal spouse life. Okay. So Heavenly Father, we thank you for this revelation. We thank you for the wisdom you have given us, Father. We thank you for turning our attention to scripture, letting us know how the spirit of poverty has come upon our life and even our prodigal spouse's life, Father. And so as a result, we reject this spirit of poverty in the name of Jesus Christ. We break off your God-ordained spouses and your prodigal spouses, the spirit of poverty in the name of Jesus Christ. We reject the spirit of laziness. We reject rejecting wise counsel, advice, and even the scripture, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. We reject operating in our own pleasures and chasing fantasies and worthless pursuits that's going after things that are fruitless because of being infatuated with with this thing. And even being stingy in heart, Father, we reject these things in the name of Jesus Christ. We renounce it. We come out of agreement with it, Father. And we ask that you will place us in a land called Jireh. We ask that you will bring upon us understanding and wisdom, Father, and the spirit of prosperity. So we thank you, Father, that who the Son has set free is free indeed. In Jesus' name, we also ask that you will give our prodigal spouses wisdom and understanding and knowing how the poverty spirit has come upon them, that poverty mindset is now in operation in them. We break that off of them in the name of Jesus Christ. But I do pray and ask that you will move our spouses into a level of understanding, a level of breaking off these spirits off of them in the name of Jesus Christ and walking according to your spiritual laws that are found in the Bible, Father. We thank you. We pray this prayer in your son, Jesus' name. Amen.